그래, 과.
People think it's cool, some people think it's funny, and the one who thinks it's normal, I'ma call it Hermione. Not much going on besides my two best friends, my friend and this little tiny really, really, really funny bug. And if you're mean to it, I'll fuck you up, la-di-da, a pug. He's got a mashed up face,
and he's the size of a mug, a pug.
Hello and welcome to the first ever episode of Pugs and Mugs, Sipping Stories with CuppaPug. I'm here with Matthew. Hello, Matthew.
Hello.
We'll set the tone for you today. So we have just finished a very busy Sunday. The pugs are asleep in the cafe still. We're here.
Might hear some snoring.
If you hear the snoring, that's the pugs, all of them together. They've had a very busy day. We've had puppy day upstairs. The pugs have been downstairs, fully booked. If you've come here, you know that we are fully booked 2 to 3 weeks in advance. It's been mad. But we've been wanting to do this for a while. So many people come from all over the world. They come here and they want to know how we started the cafe. They want to know about the pugs. They want to know what they're up to, what their favourite foods are, what they're doing when they're not here, who looks after them. And we thought, what the best way to do this is to actually have our own podcast.
Yes.
We've got our tea. We're going to need it after today. Yeah. So we're going to sit down. We're going to have a chat with you. You can ask us any questions that you want for future episodes as well. So any questions you have about the pugs, about the cafe, about us, anything you want to know, drop a comment, leave it with us, email us, and we'll get back to you in another video. But to start with, our first episode is all going to be about how we started CuppaPug.
Yes.
So we're 18 months in.
Yeah.
We have had, it's been an absolute whirlwind. Like, I think we always knew it was going to be popular, but not to this level.
Yeah, not thinking about how popular.
Or not so quick as well.
Yes.
And I think the beauty behind that has been everyone that has come to CuppaPug has absolutely loved it. I think they've come with a little bit of curiosity. They don't know what it is, what the setup is, who looks after the pugs, how well looked after they are. So it's good to be able to show them, tell them about it a bit more. And it's just, I think it's gone so quick because everyone has just been so amazing. You know, every single customer that we've had has really just been in awe of it, I think. And that's been really nice.
And they've been very generous with telling us how much they've loved it, how much I think we read the messages when they say, thank you very much for sharing your pugs with us. And I feel that comment, that in itself is like, wow, this is what CuppaPug is. This is what we do.
I don't think we really thought of it like that before, did we? In terms of, oh, we're sharing our pugs with people. And actually, when someone first said that to me, I was taken back a little bit. I was like, we're sharing our pugs. We are. But in the best way.
Yes.
Like, if you have pugs, if you've ever been around pugs, you know that they need constant attention. They have so much energy. They always need hugs and cuddles, and they need to be near you the whole time.
Well.
Treats. It's a better way to do it with the cafe as well. And, you know, Matt and I still have our day jobs. You know, Matt's been filming today. He's an actor. I had a show last night. So we're still doing our jobs, and we do CuppaPug.
Mm.
So we'll tell you more about that, I'm sure, in another episode. But for now, let's take it back to the cafe.
Mm.
Let's look at the first couple of months when we were actually even thinking about it, thinking about opening the cafe. So, Matt, what was your first thought when I said to you, look, I want to open a pug cafe?
Oh, my first thought. Let me think all the way back then. I think my initial first thought was, seems like a bit of a bonkers idea.
I think everyone did, yeah.
just because I was like, I'd known what a cat cafe is, but we don't really know what dog cafes are. Like, we know there's dog friendly, but there's no sort of dog cafes with resident dogs there. So it was like, how would that work? How many pugs do we need? Where do we get pugs from? Would it be popular? Would people travel? Would people come and see them? Would they like it? Would they enjoy it? So I think my initial setup was like, this is a bit bonkers.
Completely. I think the reason you were thinking like that, because we didn't know the answers.
No, we didn't know. I had no idea.
How many pugs we need, how many people we'd get, how many people we could have. Would the pugs enjoy it? I think that was probably a big concern, wasn't it? Will the pugs want to be here all day? Will they want to see new people all the time? You know, and that was probably our one risk that we thought, do you know what? If the pugs don't like it, we close.
Yeah.
You know, and that we said that from the beginning. Like, if it's not them, if they're not the same, if they change their character and personalities, then we wouldn't continue.
Yeah.
But it was the complete opposite. Mm. I think it was really the making of them. I think especially more of the shy ones. And I think, you know, they have seen, you know, they probably see between like 20 and 30 different pugs a week. Mm-hmm. You know, they're spending a good hour with each of them.
Socialization is brilliant for
150 yeah. people a day, up to 150 people a day. The snoring is so intense right now.
I think they're deliberately doing it. They know. They're like, they know we're filming something.
And they don't even snore. They don't even snore. Normally. So I think, you know, to be able to see how well they enjoyed it and, you know, to add gun to the story, mm-hmm. you know, he's been here, what, 2 months now? And he's taken to it like a duck to water, you know. This is all he's known, really.
Yeah.
So, and he loves it. He absolutely loves it. So, those first couple of months, what was one of your biggest concerns?
If people would want to come, people would want to book. It's like you're right about people being skeptical is the word.
Curious
yeah. but I think that curiosity draws more and more people in, because then through that curiosity they come and discover what we are, what CuppaPug is, that they are pets first. And yeah, I think the main concern was whether people would come, book in.
Yeah, I think we have to give a big shout out to the, you know, if you came in the first maybe 3 months of CuppaPug, you know, you were the test ground. You really were. And I think in the best way possible, because it was you lot that went out and told everyone about us. You know, word of mouth has been, you know, the way that this business has grown so quickly. And I think that just goes down to the testament of people just testing it, you know, checking out who we are, what we do, having a great time, having a really great experience, and then telling people about it, you know. And I think that for me really hit home. I was like, you know, we've got something here, because people are loving this as well. And it's, I think we take it for granted being around pugs all day. We don't maybe accept the, you know, the pug therapy, you know, and what they give to us on a daily basis.
Or if people know they're missing their pugs, or they're far from home, and they come in, and it can be people who are like directly in there, interacting with the pugs, getting right in there into the ball pit, the beds, and those that just sit back and like and just want to admire, or just to sit around pugs.
For sure, yeah. For sure. So we're going to take you back. We'll tell you the story about how we came up with the cafe, what the story was, and how it actually came to be. So we used to live here at Nobility Plaza. We had a flat here. We had four pugs at the time. We had Gaston, Bruce, Bowser, and Gizmo. And the shutter was up on the shop front. It was completely empty, completely bare, completely white. And I walked past and I thought, this could be a good space for the pug cafe. Not too big, not too small. It could work. We could try it out. Now, the idea we had 7 years ago when we first got Gaston, and I think I had the idea of Pug Cafe because I wanted more pugs, firstly. I wanted more pugs. But it was more about, obviously, we know Gaston had really bad separations anxiety. We wanted to get him out, get him a little bit more sociable. And we searched like pug cafes and everything. And there wasn't one that we could get to. There was always pop-up cafes where we could never get to the location, or obviously they're at weekends, and obviously both of our jobs were very weekend based as well. We used to go to the pug meets in Green Park,
wasn't it?
Green Park, the first Saturday of every month. Yes. We used to live in Soho, so it was a lot easier for us. And we wanted more. We wanted to, you know, give more to Gaston as well. You know, 5 years later, no one had still done a pug cafe. We were coming out of COVID, coming out of lockdown. Where the pugs had been around us all the time, you know, even when we were working. I had to do a lot of work in lockdown, so they were just always around our feet. And I was like, I want more for them. I don't want them to have this life.
They seemed a bit, they were like, lockdown, working from home. Although we were working from home, they had that slight boredom. They wanted that interaction with other people, other dogs.
Yeah.
They wanted that socialisation, particularly as our grumble was getting bigger. So we needed to find, a way that we could be with them as well at all times.
Now, when we found this unit, it had nothing in it. Zero, zilch. And we had no money. We had no resources. We had nothing. We had pugs.
I didn't have the vision. I was like, this can't be.
We had nothing. We only had 4 pugs. And I went to the landlord and I said, look, I've got this idea for a pug cafe. I have no money, but give it to me for 3 months and let us see what we do. Let me see if I can build it and if people would come. Mm. And that was it. We had 3 months and we created the Facebook account, the website, and put it out there. So look, we're opening a pug cafe. We didn't have a pug cafe. We had a space.
It's coming.
It's coming. And we set a date. Yeah. We set that date for June 30th. Because my birthday was the 29th. So we had a test run with our friends.
The day.
For my birthday. Yeah, so June 30th we opened. And we made it. We just made it. We did think to ourselves, if we weren't completely finished, we had a place and pugs. Yeah. So there'd be somewhere for people to come. But, you know, we were astounded because we put it out there that we were opening. And straight away, people started booking.
Mm-hmm.
And this is off the back of our small poster on the window. People would walk past, ask us what we were doing. The community in Haggerston, in Hackney, have been amazing, fantastic. Everyone that walks past, you see them walk past the window, they stop, they smile, there's such a grin on their face.
We're having like a bad day. You can tell that they're just, you know, just going about their time, and then they'll look and see the bright pink, bright lights, pugs, and that smile is like...
It does. It's a good testament, I think. Yeah. Just if you walk past and smile, then come in. So we had nothing. And, you know, I had a very, very good friend, Eddie, who is an interior designer. And he came in, he helped us work out the best way of using the space and utilizing it. And some of the crazy ideas he said absolutely no to, like the slide I wanted from the top floor to the bottom floor, that went out.
Yeah, I don't know how we could...
Not here.
So
we had a lot of friends that kind of helped us along as well. But still, I think everyone was skeptical. Everyone was thinking... It's great, but it's a niche idea. Might work for a pop-up, not permanent, maybe a couple of months, and then it would die down. Mm. And I think it was the opposite. You know, within 3 weeks, we were fully booked, I think, the first 3 or 4 months.
Mm.
And it was intense, you know. And it was what I liked about that is if you've come back, and I think in those first 6 to 8 months, like, a lot of people were coming back regularly to start with, and they were helping us, they were giving us feedback, do this, do that, I'd like this. And we took all of that on board, you know, absolutely everything. And we didn't really have any negative comments or negative feedback. I think the only thing that people would ask was, what happens to the pugs? Where do they stay? Yeah. And obviously we can answer those and put people to ease that. They have the best life all the time.
Privileged pugs.
So we were here. We were half pink. We'd only painted half of it. We couldn't find these pugs, could we? We had to end up making these a year later. But we were here. We were open. And we had that trial and error, didn't we? And... You know, I'm so happy that it worked out, mainly for us, but also for the pugs, because I think they absolutely love it. They know when we're coming here, they get so excited. If you've been here at 11 o'clock on a Thursday, when you're the first people they see of the week.
Grand entrance down the stairs.
Wow. You'll know that they're excited to see us as well.
And the pugs that we've met along the way and are like our pug pals. They get to socialise with them all the time.
Completely. Obviously, one of our first pug pals was Hercules.
Yes.
Everyone loves Hercules. They come and everyone's like, oh, is Hercules in today? Can you see Hercules? And, you know, just being able to meet, like, the pugs and the people as well has been fantastic. You know, you'll never be short of conversation when you're walking down the street with a pug.
Yeah.
And we have 7. We can't walk more than 10 metres without someone wanting to stop us. Speak to us about the pugs. Speak directly to the pugs. Want to hug them, kiss them, play with them. Give them their life savings. I'm sure they would. They've done it. They do it all. And it's the same here. You know, you can have so many people come on their own. Mm-hmm. I love it when people come here on their own, sit down, start, you know, playing with the pugs. And then by the, you know, 5 minutes into the session... Everyone is just talking to each other. Everyone has, you know, the love for it.
Offering to like, oh, I can take a picture for you. If a pug's just jumped on, they've got a toastie in one hand, a latte in the other hand. They're like, oh, I can get you. Yeah, it's a community inside here as well.
It is. And I think that's what's helped us so much as well. That, you know, having a community of people that love pugs, wants to be part of the community as well. And remember, you do not need a pug to come to the cafe. You can come without a pug, You can come and play with the resident pugs and the pug pals that we have as well. But you can also bring your pug as well. So if you have a pug, please bring them to the cafe. Please bring them to CuppaPug. Use code PUGPALS and you'll get 50% off one of your tickets as well. Mm. So we love seeing
pugs. Yep, we love our pug pals.
Do not be apprehensive about bringing your pug if you think your pug is naughty or crazy or will cause havoc and upset everything. That's why we have this space. It's a pug space first. So they can come, they can be naughty, they can play with the pugs, they can jump in the ball pit, they can have their little accidents. Mm-hmm. We love it. You know, you're their guests. So pugs first. So please bring your pugs. We want to see all the pugs. So Matthew, let me ask you. Okay. When we first opened, those first couple of months, mm-hmm. what were you most surprised at?
I think I was... The most surprised was how well the pugs... like adapted to this. It's like they the pugs have made this space their own. Because we, like you said, we weren't too sure if they were going to like it, and if they weren't going to like it, we would obviously have to change mm-hmm. what we were doing. But I think I can remember. I wish I knew the person's name. But when they came in, they sat down, and then Bruce just instantly like ran up, chuttered along, barked, and sat on their lap. And Bruce was just like sat there, and then it was that moment. I was like, yeah, they love it, but they love it and it's their space and they're just enjoying it so much.
Yeah, Bruce will claim people.
Yeah.
If you come in and you sit down and Bruce sits on your lap, you're one of his. None of the others. You're one of his. And he'll do that a lot as well. Especially if you're sat by the mural. That seems to be his area. Yeah, sit by the window or the mural. He likes that. He'll come over. You're right. I think the pugs just took to it so easy. Mm. And again, I think that put us at ease as well. I think what's for me, I mean, I think what has been really good is our partnership with the charity, with the National Pug Protection Trust. So being able to have somebody or a team of people to be able to just help us and guide us a little bit more around like the welfare of the pugs, how much they should do, what mm-hmm. they shouldn't do. And as much as there wasn't anything there, but just being able to have someone there to just guide us through that part of the process as well, because we are running a business. We want to make sure it's successful, and we don't want to take sight of, you know, the pugs and their welfare. So to be able to have someone who can be accountable, we can be accountable to as well. And to check up, I think has been really good. And then, you know, to have the charity here as well really allows people, you know, so many people come here, they want a pug. They will come here to do their research. Mm-hmm. They don't know if they want to rescue, if they want a puppy. They don't know the difference between, like, how to do it or anything. They come here, we'll sit down with them, we'll have a conversation with them. And if rescuing is right for them... Those footprints...
Strudel, babe. To hold him. Strudel. He doesn't settle. Strudel, come.
Just make sure I don't do the wires. No, Bruce.
Bed.
No. No. Bed. 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 It's going to get hot. We've now been joined. We had to stop for a minute because we've now been joined by Gizmo. Follow very quickly by Strudel, who we're looking after at the moment.
Pug pal.
Our pug pal. We have him for 3 weeks. He's loving it.
Strudel.
We'll continue. So, yes. You know, people will come here if rescuing is for them, if they're able to do it, because sometimes it can be a little bit more work. You have to give them a little bit more time. Mm. If it's for them, you know, being able to have the charity that we can, you know, send them on to and get that advice, you know, it's been fantastic to see people come full circle.
Yeah.
You know, they come here, they don't know if they want a pug, they, you know, they'll convince the dad, you know, a pug is for them, for the family. And then they'll speak to the charity, and then they'll end up rescuing a pug. And then when they can, they'll bring it here. And that's great, because we can't have that many more pugs.
No. You know?
So at the moment, I'm living vicariously through other people who get pugs, you know, through the charity.
And it's that full circle moment, I think, of people coming in, wanting a pug, finding out about the charity, contacting the charity, and then unbeknownst to us, they return and they have a pug that they got from the charity.
Yeah, that's really good, isn't it? I really like that. So if you are looking for a pug, you know, you can go onto the charity's website. Go to the National Pug Protection Trust's Instagram.
Their Instagram, yeah.
The Instagram is fantastic. Really look at the pugs that they have who need homes. They are adorable. Mm. We got Bo from the charity, and he is so lovable.
Bobo.
He's so, so lovable. He's such a good addition here. And we couldn't be without him now, could we? So we got him from him, and that's really good. So Matthew, if someone hasn't come to the cafe,
yes,
if they're standing outside, they're about to come in, what can they expect? Talk them through that 60 minutes that they're going to get here. Not minute for minute, but talk us through.
What have we got time? So I think the very first thing is once they put their hand on that door handle and they open up, they will expect a grumble of very curious pugs running over towards the gate. Maybe with a Bruce bark, a Bowser bark here and there, a Gaston barking, wanting, knowing that they want attention. They want to know who these people are. And as soon as you sit down, they're straight onto you. We come around with some carrots just so that they could become familiar with people when we give them some treats. But within the space, we always say, like, you are guests in their home, and they play and interact just like they are at home. So you can see them running around, zoomies, some will be sleeping in the bed. Best way to interact with them, you can buy treats. So we have the pug treats, the puppuccino, the strawberries, and the sausages, which does come with a disclaimer.
Let me stop you there, Matthew. So we have the three treats. Explain why we have three treats and the difference in them.
Okay, so the puppuccino, it's frothed soy milk. That is perfect for anyone who is a bit sort of timid, a bit shy in terms of feeding directly to dogs. You hold a small cup with puppuccino in, and you can easily share it amongst them. So it's not too chaotic. So it's good for people who are just a bit less confident with, I think, around pugs, or great for children. Strawberries, it's a nice strawberry bowl. They love the sweetness, the juiciness of the strawberries. They are for those who are a bit more confident. You feed them directly to the pug's mouth. We obviously always say to everyone, roll out flat palm so they don't bite your fingers. And then the sausages. Now, we always say sausages come with a disclaimer, because it's going to be very chaotic, because they love the sausages. Absolutely love the sausages. And as soon as that bowl is in someone's hand, you have pugs balancing on your head, pugs grabbing your arm. They want that treat. So it comes in varying degrees of intensity.
They do. Those sausages do come with the disclaimer. They will be overeaten. Yeah. And they do look like people's fingers, so be careful. As well, for sure. Hey, Gizmo. The one thing you talk about the pugs, that's amazing. But there's so much more that you can do as well.
Yeah.
So obviously we have our pug treats. The ink information explained, we have our pug themed drinks and snacks as well. Did you know that every single pug has its own signature cocktail? And you can have that during the day now as well. So we have Gizmo's Cosmo.
Mm-hmm.
We have Gaston's One Eyed Brew.
That's popular.
Very popular now. Yeah. Bruce the Batman.
Yeah.
Bo Star Martini. We have Bowser's
Espresso Martini,
thank you, there we go, it's been a long day.
Balloon Necessity,
there is a new one coming.
Oh yeah.
So Gun.
Oh yeah.
We're not going to tell you what it is yet, but Gun's is going to be the Gunshot.
The Gunshot, yeah.
So if you're fancying, joining the pugs with a cocktail, come and join us. It's the great combination.
And also our CuppaPug Pilsner.
Of course, the very, very CuppaPug, very, very popular CuppaPug Pilsner as well. We have two Pilsners. A large Pilsner, yeah. And then a gluten-free one as well. So if you need that, come and grab it as well. Obviously, we have all our merchandise as well. Mm-hmm. So if you want to take a piece of CuppaPug home with you, you can. We have our tote bag, which is new.
We have our mugs.
You're all going to want them now. Obviously, they fly out the door. We cannot get them quick enough. And coming soon, very, very soon, is Gizmo's Pugalet.
Oh, yeah.
So that is chocolate for humans. Don't give it to your dog.
Not for dogs, no.
As well, that's coming in December 2023, Gizmo's Pugalet. You can only buy it in the cafe.
Yeah.
So we're not shipping it. It's only available in store. So only those that come into the cafe can get Gizmo's chocolate. Can't they?
And of course it's Gizmo.
Of course it's Gizmo.
Gizmo's first.
Gizmo's one of the brains. He's the boss. It's his chocolate. Isn't it, Gizmo? You're the boss.
Oh, side eye.
You tell him. He's snoring right into your mic there.
I know. If
you're watching on YouTube, you're going to be able to see little strudel here, a little bit sleepy. Gizmo just wants to know what's going on.
Yeah.
As well. So that's drinks, that's pugs, that's how we found the place in the first place.
Yeah.
Let's just go on. So firstly, I want to say thank you all so much for your questions. We're going to answer those in a separate podcast, which will go out this week as well. So we'll get to your questions. But again, if you have any questions about the pugs, the cafe, about us, absolutely anything you want to know, get in touch on social media, comment below, let us know what your questions are. We'll get to them as soon as we can.
Mm.
The one thing I would advise people, if they're coming to CuppaPug, please book. Yes. Please go on the website and book. I think this week alone, we have had, I think, about 60 people that we've had to turn away this week alone just because we've been fully booked. Like I said before, we've pretty much filled 2 to 3 weeks in advance.
Yeah.
So if you're thinking about joining in 2024, make sure you book online, especially if you're on holiday. Please book in advance. You know, we have so many people that come and plan their vacations around CuppaPug. It's amazing. But we also have those people that come on holiday, find out about us, and then try and come in the last couple of days of the holiday, and we can never fit them in.
Yeah.
So we really need you to book online to guarantee your spot as well. There's more to come. We have Manchester coming as well. We'll be doing a completely whole podcast on Manchester as soon as we can give you more details. I'm sure there's lots of questions about it. Everyone's very excited. We had over 1,000 signups in the first 12 hours of people just wanting to know more about Manchester.
Yeah, so people with pugs in Manchester.
And the last 2 weeks, I think it's nearly 5,000. 5,000 people already are signed up to hear about Manchester. Hey, Gizmo, are you coming to Manchester?
He's the boss, so he needs to oversee.
We are also in New York.
Yeah.
This week, later in this week, setting up CuppaPug New York as well. They're all going to work very differently as well. But all very exciting as well. So any questions about all of that, get in touch, let us know. We'll answer all those questions as and when we can. But to round up, please make sure you book if you're visiting CuppaPug. Please like and subscribe to us everywhere where you're watching this. Make sure you share this podcast every single week with your friends. If they're feeling down, your friends that love dogs, especially pugs. Thank you all so much. This has been Pugs and Mugs, Sipping Stories with CuppaPug. And we'll be back real soon.
He's got a mashed up face.
And he's the size of a mug, a pug.